राधा श्याम सुंदर देव जूपी जय। श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराण की जय। जय जय श्री राधे श्याम गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय। ओम नमो भगवते पुराण पुरुषोत्तमाय। ओम जय पराशर सूनु सत्यवती हृदय नंदोव्यासोंमंगत वाग्मय ममतम जगत्पिबती विश्वसंसर्गा नवलक्षण लक्षित श्रीकृष्णाक्ष परमधाम जगद्धाम नमामि तत्। हृदय से प्रेरणया प्रवर्तितोऽहं वरापरूपोऽपि तस्य हरे पदकमलं वंदे श्रीचैतन्यदेवस्य वंदेहम श्रीगुरो श्रीपकमल श्रीगुरू वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साधुजात सह गण रघुनाथान्वित सजीव साद्वैत सवभूत पंजन सहित श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्यदेव श्रीराधा श्रीपद सह गण ललता श्री शाखान्विताश्च आयाकुजंगावदातर कमलायताक्ष विश्वभरौ प्रियवरौ युगधर्मपालौ तमुदेजनप्रियकरौ करुणाकारौ नारायणस्तुते नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासपुत्रपूज्यमीरये योऽन्तःप्रविश्य मम वाचं मां प्रसुप्तां सन्धिनिवेत्यग्निशक्तिधरस्व भावना अन्यांश्च हस्तचरणश्रीमत्वरामि प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम् परम श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण वेरी वेरी ऑस्पिशियस श्री श्री श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण प्रीवियसली श्रुति हैज कंक्लूडेड जय डेट श्री हरि यू आर द ओनली रेस्पेक्टेबल एंड वर्शिपेबल थिंग एंड यू हैव द अचिंत्य भेदाभेद विद योर शक्तिस एंड वी आर डिस्क्राइबिंग योर अचिंत्य भेदाभेद दैट मीन्स योर शक्तिस दोज आर indifferent to you, even then they are found different from you. Shri Shruti has in this way described that Bhagavan is always full of Shakti and their Shaktis are sometimes manifested and sometimes not. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, 42, second verse. Ityetat Brahmaputra Ashutya Atmanushasanam. Shri Badrinarayan Bhagavan, Narayan is saying to Shri Narayan. In this way, they all, Brahmaputra, son of Sanandana, Sanatana, son of Kumar, they are the sons of Shri Brahma, and they Ashwati Atman Shashanam. They heard that what is Atman, and listening the Atman Shashan, listening that thing, that Atma is Brahma. Atma that is pervading everywhere, and who is the base? Atatvat, Matritvat, Atma. Why? Whole upadhi or designations will be removed, then this thing will remain, that is Atma. And in everything which is permanent, that is Atma. For Atma has two qualities, all permanentness and the basicness, who will remain at last. That is Atma. So Atman Shashanam, where the description of Atma is described, Shri Sanandana Rishi was the orator and the other persons was audience, and they were listening how Shruti praised Shri Krishna. And Shri Naradji was listening this in Badrakashram Dham from Shri Bhagavan, Shri Badrinarayan Bhagavan. Sanandanam, Sanandanam Athanarchu. They are all Siddha and they respected Sanandana Rishi. They worship Sanandana Rishi. Gyatva Atmanugatim. And in this way, they came to know their own gati, their own destinations, transcendental destinations, Atmanugatim. Iti Ashesh Samamnaya, Purana Upanishad Rasa. Shri Badrinarayan Bhagavan is describing to Shri Narada. O Narada, in this way, I have represented the matter of all Upanishad, Ved and Purana. Iti Ashesh Samamnaya. In this way, Ashesh means the whole Samamnaya. That means the Vedas is described here. Purana or Upanishad. I have described whole Purana, the nectar, the gist of all whole Puranas, and Upanishad Rasa, the Upanishad, that is also described by me. Upanishad Rasa. I have represented the ras, the nectar of Upanishads to you. Samudrata Puru Jate, Vyomyami Maharshi. And this nectar was collected by your ancestors. Vyomyami, who always moves in the sky and who does not touch even the earth. Mahatmabhi, and who are very, very great. They have described this description. So this description is very much correct as well as very much profound. From Chaitanya Brahmadaya, Shuddhi Atmanu Shashanam, धारण तुम चेत बंदाया यू आर माय सन बंदाया ओ नारद यू आर माय सन शुद्धात्मान साधनम यू शुड फॉलो दिस आत्मान शासनम दिस डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट आत्मा आत्मतत्व आत्मतत्व मीन्स द बेसिक यू शुड रिमेंबर तुम चीत ब्रह्मदायादो ओ सन ऑफ ब्रह्मा नारद शुद्धि आत्मान शासनम धारण यू रिमेंबर दिस डिस्क्रिप्शन दैट डिस्क्राइब्स अबाउट आत्मा चरण काम कामन कामानम भजनम गुणाम एंड यू नाउ रोम नाउ यू मूव इन होल यूनिवर्स एंड यू गो ऑल्सो टू द अर्थ कामानाम भजन निर्माण वाइल यू विल रिसाइट दिस देन कामानाम भजनम निर्माण यू विल कट यू विल डिस्ट्रॉय द हीट ऑफ काम द वार्मनेस ऑफ काम काम कामानाम भर्जनम इन दिस वे यू विल डिस्ट्रैक्ट द ऑल काम इन दिस वे द काम विल नॉट बी अगेन एबल टू रिप्रोड्यूस एनीथिंग कामानाम भर्जनम ना एज इफ ए ग्रेन that is just a dry that is bhajan that is cooked in that cooked in that in the furnish something furnish like that bhav
dry
yes ben kuch to I don't know bhav bhav so if it is bhoomli aage aage in bhav then it is not it will not remain able to saw and able to reproduce the plant so kamanam bhajanam na shri shukdev says evam sa vishna adhishtam grihitva shuddhi atmavan पूर्ण शुद्धरो राजन आह वीरव्रतो मुनि इन दिस वे ऋषणाधिष्टम एज श्री ऋषि माने बद्रीनारायण भगवान नारायण भगवान इन दिस वे बद्रीनारायण भगवान हैज डिस्क्राइब दिस वेदस्तुति टू श्री नारद ग्रीता शुद्ध आत्मवान नारद है एक्सेप्टेड विद शुद्धा दिस होल प्रीचिंग्स विद देन रेस्पेक्ट ही हैज एक्सेप्टेड दिस प्रीचिंग्स एंड पूर्ण शुद्धरा नारद इन दिस वे बिकेम पूर्ण ही फुलफिल्ड एंड शुद्धरा नारद वाज वेरी मच इंटेलिजेंट and whatever he heard he remembered it shuddhara means he grasped it shuddhara he remembered it so purna nar became satisfied and fulfilled as well as shuddhara narad had accepted and remembered it only by hearing Shuddhara is called the person who can remember all the things only by hearing. and he has not to crank the sentences. That is called Shuddha. Raja Nahir Topuni and Sri Narad in this way replied to Sri Padri Narayan Bhagwan. This dialogue is originally is being between Sri Narad and Badri Narayan Bhagwan, and Badri Narayan Bhagwan is reproducing the dialogue that was held in Satyalok, in Chandlok, sorry, in Chandlok with Sanatan, with Sanandan Rishi and the other Siddhas. And they was describing how Shruti pray to Shri Narayan. Narad is praying Shri Badri Narayan Bhagwan. Namastasmai Bhagavate Krishnaya Malakirtaye Yohate Sarvabhutanam Abhavaya Ushati Kala. I am offering my salute to Namastasmai Bhagavate, who is Bhagwan and who has all glories. Namastasmai Bhagavate. Krishnaya Amalkirtaye. Shri Badri Narayan Bhagwan is Krishna. That means he has all knowledge and everlasting. Amal Kirtai, his Kirti, his glories are very great and clean. Amal Kirtai, his glories are very much clean. A great shining glories. Yodhate Sarvabhutanam Abhavaya. You have taken your incarnation for the welfare of every person. Sarvabhutanam Abhavaya. And get them, Abhav means moksha, so that the other persons can get moksha. Sarvabhutanam Abhavaya. Ushiti Kala. You have this kala by which the person will get moksha, and ushiti means it is very much beautiful. Ushiti means beautiful. Kala means phrase. So you have the phrase, that means the gyan. Bhagavan has so many qualities, and one quality is one face is one phrase is gyan, and you have it. So yodhate, you bear sarvabhutanam abhavaya for the liberation of every person. Ushiti kala, the phrase of Shri Krishna, that is very much ushiti, very much shine. Ushiti kala is called gyan. Gyan is called a kala of Shri Krishna. That means a very little phrase of Shri Krishna. Little face of Shri Krishna. Expansion, yes. Yes, expansion. A very little expansion of Shri Krishna. As there is moon, and sometimes moon is very much little, and sometimes it is full moon. So while it is full moon, then he has the whole six kala. And gradually, on 15 days, the kala Chandrama gets five kalas. So what will you say? Phases. So he will get in the Ushti kala. Shri Krishna has so many kala, and you are also getting it. Ushti kala. इत्याद्यं ऋषिम् आनन्द्यं तशिष्यांश महात्मा ततो अराध आश्रमं साक्षात् पितृ देवपालन सिंह इन दिस प्ले इति आदि ऋषि से बद्रीनारायण भगवान इन बद्रकाश्रम धाम बद्रीनारायण हिमालय बद्रकाश्रम इति आद्यम ऋषि श्री नारद सेल्यूटेड नारद पे हिज रेस्पेक्ट टू श्री बद्रकाश्रम श्री नारायण ऋषि एन आनंद ऑफरिंग हिज सेल्यूट टू हिम तत्शिष्यांश देर आर सो मेनी शिष्य ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट एट दैट टाइम श्री नारद ऑल्सो सेल्यूटेड देम पे हिज ओबीएंसेस टू देम प्रणाम टू हिम तत्शिष्यांश महात्मा ततो अगाध आश्रम साक्षात एंड देन श्री नारद वेंट टू व्यास आश्रम लक्ष्मी शम्यप्रास वेयर श्री वेदव्यास वाज रिजाइडिंग सो तत्र अगाध आश्रम साक्षात पितुर्द्वैपायन अस्मि ही वेंट टू द आश्रम वेयर माई फादर शुक्रजी सिंह वेयर माई फादर श्री द्वैपायन ऋषि वेदव्यास वाज रिजाइडिंग सभाको भगवता कृतासन परिग्रह इन दिस वे सभाजको भगवता एज श्री वेदव्यास श्री नारद रीच्ड टू वेदव्यास आश्रम वेदव्यास स्टूड एंड ही रेस्पेक्टेड श्री नारद एज नारद वाज हिज गुरु एंड ही रेस्पेक्टेड हिज गुरु तो सभाजी तो भगवता कृतासन परिग्रह एंड श्री नारद हैज एक्सेप्टेड हिज आसन एज वेल एज हिज वर्शिप परिग्रह व्हाट एवर ऑफरिंग्स श्री वेदव्यास ऑफर टू श्री नारद ऋषि श्री नारद ऋषि Shri Narada has accepted all those offerings. So, Tasmai Tam Dvanyamasa Narayan Mukhachyotam. Whatever Narada heard from Shri Badrinarayan Bhagavan, he represented it, reproduced it. To Shri Vedavyas. Shri Narada told his story, his biography, and then he preached Shri Srimad Bhagavat. That means this Veda Stuti, where the four things are described. विषय तत्व इज श्री कृष्ण अध्यय तत्व इज साधन भक्ति प्रयोजन पदार्थ इज प्रेम दक्षिण भक्ति एंड द अधिकारी इज द शुद्धावान व्यक्ति तो अधिकारी विषय संबंधित प्रयोजन दिस फोर थिंग्स दैट कंटेंट्स इन दिस श्रुति स्तुति ही रिप्रोड्यूस्ड ही रिसाइटेड This Shruti Stuti to Shri Vedavyasa. So Tasmai means to Vedavyasa Tad Varnyamasa Narayana Mukhachyotam. Whatever he learned it from Shri Narayana, he reproduced it to Shri Vedavyasa. Itya Tad Varnyatam Rajan Yadna Prashna Tapastaya. In this way, we have described whatever you have presented, you ask, I have answered this. So, ithe the Vrnitam Rajan, yanna prashna svayakrita. Previously, you have, in the beginning of this chapter, Shri Parikshita has put the question, कि ब्रह्मन ब्रह्मन निर्देश्य निर्गुणे गुणवृत्तया कथम चलन्ति श्रुतयः. कि ब्रह्म इज अनिर्देश्य, वी कैन नॉट बी डिस्क्राइब्ड, अनडिस्क्राइबल, एंड ब्रह्म इज निर्गुण, दैट मीन्स प्राकृत गुण है. हाउ श्रुति कैन डिस्क्राइब हिम? एंड श्री वेद शुकदेव जी आंसर दैट दिस कैन नॉट बी सेड दैट ब्रह्म इज अनिर्देश. अनिर्देश मीन्स ब्रह्म इज अनेबल टू डिस्क्राइब. ब्रह्म इज अनडिस्क्राइबल बाय प्राकृत लैंग्वेज और प्राकृत मन और प्राकृत इंद्रिय. बाय आवर मेटेरियल आईज, मेटेरियल लैंग्वेज एंड मेटेरियल माइंड वी कैन नॉट डिस्क्राइब ब्रह्म. बट इफ श्री श्रुति आर देयर, बिकॉज श्रुति आर ट्रांसलेंटल, बाय ट्रांसलेंटल श्रुतिज ब्रह्म कैन बी डिस्क्राइब. By a material language, Brahm cannot be described. But by transcendental Shruti, Brahm can be described. The second thing is this, that Brahma is not a material thing, but he has the whole qualities and actions. And his action and qualities are transcendental. Brahma is not made of the material goods and material qualities, but Brahma has numberless great qualities and great good. So you cannot say that Brahma is without quality. Brahma is someone, and but his goals are not material. And Brahma is describable, but not by the material language and material mind and limbs, senses. Brahma can be described only by by bhakti. One has got the transcendental senses within him and he is using the transcendental language, then Brahm can also be described. So Brahm is nirgun, that means he is prakrut guna rahit, but he has the transcendental or guna within him. So whatever you have asked, I have answered. Yatha Brahmani Anirdeshe Durgule Vishnu Tuchare. Though Brahma is Anirdeshe, he cannot be described by the material language and senses. And he is Durgun. His qualities and glories are not material, but they are transcendental. And Shruti can describe it. And at last, one verse is given here. Shri Shukdev is giving one verse, and by that verse, he is praying Shri Krishna, describing the four things: Adhikari, Sambandha, Abdheya, and Prayoga. And the conclusion of whole Shruti Stuti is concluded in this. Yes. Adhikari, Sambandha, Abhidheya, Abhidheya, that means Sadhan Bhakti.
The first thing you said, Adhikari.
No? Adhikari, Adhikari means who is the, who is, no, Adhikari means who is competent to do this pray to Shri Krishna. That means who is competent to for this prayer. He is called Adhikari.
Adhikari
Adhikari means who has the adhikar, who has the power to understand it. Adhikari means who is capable or competent.
These four things.
Sambandh, Abhidhe and Prayoga. And these are called Anubandha Chatushtay. These four things are called Anubandha Chatushtay. Knowing these four Anubandha, four these points, a person can perfectly understand a thing unless he is not thinking of these four things. He cannot understand the theme of a granth, of a book. To know the theme of a book, one should know that who is the adhikari of this, that means who is the competent person for this book, who is eligible. Adhikari means the eligible person. Subject means what is the subject matter of this book. Abhidhe means Priyojan means what is the goal of this book. And Abhidhe means which is the way, how he can achieve that goal. So Adhikari is eligible person. He is called Adhikari. Sambandh is subject matter. Prayojan is the motive. And Abhidhe is called the way by which we can achieve that goal. So these four things are comprehensively put in a one verse. Yosyo Preksha Adhvarjya Nijude Yo Vyakta Jiveshwara Yasrishtre Manu Pramishya Rishina Chakre Purashastita Yam Sampaddi Jahatyayam Anushayo Supta Kulayam Yatha Tam Kaivalya Nirasta Yoni Mahayam Yaya Ajastram Harim. Then in last line, Shri Shukdev ji is praying, Tam Kaivalya Nirastra Yoni Mahayam Yaya Ajastram Harim. We should always meditate Shri Hari, who is Ajastra. Ajastra means who is continuously, timelessly, who is existing. There is no beginning of Brahma, and neither there is the end of Brahma. So there is no limit of Adi and Ant of Brahma. Neither Brahma has its beginning nor its end. So Ajastram, Shri Krishna is Ajastra, that means omnipotent. Shri Krishna is present at every time. He is omnipotent and ever present. He is present in everywhere as well as he is ever present, timeless. So Ajastra, and he is Hari. Hari means he always steals the sins of a person. He is Hari. He is so powerful that he will fetch, he will attract all sins, all dirts that we have in our heart, and by his kindness our whole sins and pap will be removed. And they will burn it. Hari. Hari means the thief, just say. Hari means who steals. So Shri Krishna is also have the quality to steal our sins. So Hari is Hari. The second meaning of Hari is he is very much attractive. He is Hari. He is very much attractive, very beautiful. And he just steals our heart. So he is called Hari, Ajasram Hari. We will always serve Shri Krishna. Dhyaye Ajasram Hari. Now the qualities of Shri Krishna is described in first line. Yose asi uprechata. Shri Krishna is the seer of this whole universe. Unless Shri Krishna has seen Maya Devi, this world cannot be produced. So yo asi uprechata. It means not touching. Even then, he is just having an eye on whole universe. So your asi means universe. Utprekshaka means is the viewer, who is the viewer of this whole universe. Yosutprekshaka. Adhimatyan nidhane. He is everywhere, every time, before this universe, while it is, the universe is in existence at that time, and while it is not remain and it will be destroyed at the time of Pralaya. Srishti, Sthiti and Pralaya, in whole three times, Yo Asi Upekshaka, who is the gazer, who is the viewer of this whole universe. Yosur Prekshak Adhikati Nidhane. Yo Abhyakti Jiveshwara. Shri Krishna is the master of Abhyakti means Maya Devi and Jeev. He is the master of Jeev as well as Maya Devi. Through Yo Abhyakti Jiveshwara. Yas Srishtva Idam, who has created this universe. And hey, Bhagavad Gita. Yas Srishtva Idam, Anupravishya. And he entered into them. Previously, he has created these Jiva and Ishwar and this Jagat. And then he also, Anupravishya. He also entered in every one of them. Shishyodam Anupurush. Rishna Chakre Pura Shastricha. And who has taken the incarnation of a Rishi. Incarnation of Shri Narmane Rishi, or the incarnation of Shri Brahma. And by Brahma or Vedavyas, Rishna, Chakre Purashastricha. And he has created whole Shastra by which the person will do. So Shri Krishna has made the Shastra, the guidelines for this whole world. So, who has created this universe? He is every time having a sight on Brahma, having sight on this universe. Either it is before Srishti or while Srishti is there, and after Srishti, he is having sight. His sight. On this universe. He is the master of Jeev and Jagat. Jagat, he has created and entered into everything. And Vishnu Chakra, Pura Shastri, yeah. And by Brahma and Vedavyas and other rishis, he has created the Shastra, the guidelines for all persons, that they should work according to it. Yam sampadya jahat tyajam. If a person, sampadya yam, reaches to him, if a person reaches to him, sampadya, he got Brahma, then jahat tyajam, he will leave, he will kill the aja, the goat, this maya. Only by getting Shri Krishna, a person can get relief of maya. So yam sampatyo, getting Shri Krishna, jahat tyajam, a person will kill, slaughter the maya, the goat. Anushayo suptakulayam yatha. Shri Krishna is always sleeping in the heart of every person. Anushaya. Shri, if Shri Krishna is slept, Krishna is in not seeing this world, Krishna is sleeping, then whole university is, whole universe will be became slept. So jaha anushayo supta kulayam yatha. Why? Shri Krishna will sleep, then whole universe will be became slept. Kulayam yatha. In the same way, as if we sleep, the Atma is slept, then this body is also slept. So Kulayam is body. As the physical body becomes unable to work while the person is in dark sleep, sound sleep. So, while Buddhi is slept, then this body is also slept. Supta kulayam yatha tam kaivalya nirasta yoni. Why? Kaivalya. Shri Krishna became kaivalya. That means the Paramatma became kevalya. Then whole Maya Devi is merged into him. So Maya Devi merges into Shri Garbhodshayi or Sankarshana. Maya Devi merges into Sankarshana, Karnarashayi, Karnasamushayi. Brahma merges to Garbhodshayi. We jeev merges to Kshiroshayi. Brahma merges to Garbhodshayi. And this Maya, whole Maya, that merges to Shri Karnarashayi Sankarshana. So, Kaivalya, while Shri Sankarshana is Kaivalya, then Nirastha Yoni, whole Yoni are Nirastha, whole creatures and whole species are merged into Brahma. Whole species are merged into Brahma. Abhayam. Shri Krishna is abhay, nirbhay. He does not have any bhay. Yai ajastram harim. We should always remember and meditate Shri Krishna. In this day, he has described the whole thing. Shri Krishna is the main cause of everything. A person should always serve him because we are the heart, we are the Vibhinnansha, the separate particle of Brahman. And now we should serve Shri Krishna in this. Dhyay, Shri Krishna is Abhay, Dhyay Ayastram Hari. We should serve him. Anna. There is a new chapter. Shri Parikshit Maharaj has asked that Devasu Manusheshu Ye Bhajanti Ashvam Shivam Prayaste Dhanino Bhuja Nat Lakshmya Patim Hari. Among Dev, Asura and Manusha, some persons devote, some persons have devotion for Shri Shiva, and some persons are devoting Shri Krishna or Vishnu. But normally this is found that who is devoting Shri Krishna, he has Vairagya in his heart. And the person who is devoting Shri Shiva, he got so many, plenty of wealth. So it is very much strange that by serving Shri Shiva, who is in his Leela, in his pastime, who is the Shiva is Virat. He has taken the renowned system and he is having always the Tyag, Sanyam, austerity and the mortification. Even then, by serving Shri Krishna, the Shri Shiva, a person gets money. And Shri Narayana is always with Shri Lakshmi ji. So by serving the Lakshmi Pati, Shri Narayana, a person, he gets Vairagya, mortification. So this is very, very strange. What is the cause of that? So Radha Parikshit Maharaj asked ki devasu manusheshu ye bhajanti ashvam. The form and the ornaments of Shiva are not very much auspicious. He is just wrapping the snakes. He is wearing the Mundamal, the head of a dead person's skull, the garland of skull. He is just meshing the dust of a dead body on his body. Bhasma, Sham Bhasma is meshing on his body. So it is very much strange that Ashivam, his swarup is his ornaments and his dress is very much Ashivam. He is wearing the Bahamba, the skin of a lion. So, the person who serves Shri Shiva, who has a very modified position, by serving him, the person is getting money and Shiva Narayan is living in Vaikuntha Dham and it is full of prosperity and opulences, and he is with Shri Lakshmi Devi, who is the master, mistress of every opulence. Even then, the person normally who serves Shri Krishna or Shri Narayan, they have the desire, they have no attraction toward the worldly things. So it is very much strange. Prayaste dhanno bhuja nat lakshmapati bharim. The devotee of Shivji is using dhan anna lakshmapati bharim, and who is serving Shri Lakshmipati Hari is not getting so much money. Etat devut mucchami sandeho tar mahadeho. This is a great sandeh. I have this confusion. I have this question that Buddhishilu, the nature of Vishnu and Shiv, it is quite different and Vishnu contradictory. Prabhu, though both are masters, Prabhu, but Viruddha Bhastangati, but the result is seen among the devotees, that is different. So by serving Shri Shiv, a person involves in the worldly matters, and while he is serving Shri Vishnu, then he is getting relief and attraction toward the worldly matters. So what is the cause of it? Shri Shukdev is answering. So Viruddhashilyo Prabho Viruddha Bhastam Gati. They have the Viruddha Gati. And what is the cause of it? Shri Shukdev ji is answering in this way that, O King, have you ever thought that what is the money? Money is a illusion. Money is a maya. And Shri Vishnu is beyond maya. Though he is mayapati, but he is beyond maya. So by devoting Vishnu or Shri Krishna, one gets relief of maya. And Shiv always touches maya. So by serving Shri Krishna and devoting Shri, by serving Shiv or devoting Shri Shiv, a person gets maya. That is why the devotees of Shiv is found full of money, and the devotees of Vishnu is found that they have normally they like to accept the renowned system of life, Vairagya. So that is the point. In Brahma Sahita, Vishnu is described as a person has lit a second lamp from a lamp. But the second lamp does not cover the light of the first lamp. If a person is illumining the second lamp from a lamp, then the second lamp is not a cover of first lamp, but it will increase to a way the light of the length, the whole light. In the same way, Shri Krishna is Mahadipa, is a great deep, and the other person has just lit the other deep. That means Vishnu is just like a next deep, next length. But that next length is not covering the main original Deepa. In the same way, by serving Shri Krishna, the quality of being beyond Maya is not conceived. But Shiv is described in Brahma Sanhita as there is a curd, and that is mixed to the milk, and the whole milk becomes turns into the curd. Doodh mein chamal lagaya aur doodh dahi ban gaya. Whole milk is transformed into the curd. But that curd cannot be used to make a rabdi. That can be used only for the khatai, khata, soulness. 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 Khata. That can be used. But it cannot be used to make a rabdi or kheer, payas. In the same way, Shiva sometimes touches Maya. So by serving Shiva, a person will get the worldly things, the material things. But Vishnu never touches Maya. So by serving, a person will not be indulged in material attractions. The example for Brahma is given. Brahma is just like a sphatik mani, a surikant mani, a jewel. But the jewel does not has its own light. Why? It is put in the light, then the Suryakant Mani will be able to burn the other things. So in this way, Shri Brahma is Maya, and Shri Krishna has put his qualities, his virtues in Brahma. So Brahma became Ishwar. So Brahma is not Ishwar. Shiv is Ishwar. But even then, Shiv touches Maya. Vishnu is Ishwar, and he is always untouched by Maya. So in this way, serving of Vishnu will create a person transcendental, and he will get relief of a materialistic attachment. But by serving Shri Brahma or Shiva, he will get the materialistic material qualities. So that is why a devotee of Shiva is found to be very rich person, and a devotee of Vishnu is found to be a saint or a renounced man. Bolo Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai.